got a confession to make. I know it's old and it has kind of awkward styling, but I actually really, really like the current generation Tundra. It's definitely showing its age, but there's something so lovable about that fantastic V8 soundtrack, spacious interior, beautiful highway ride, and off-road capability right out of the box. However, today's customer demands even more than that. They want the best in infotainment and connectivity, and they want efficiency that that thirsty powertrain just can't deliver. Enter the all-new 2022 Toyota Tundra. Built on the company's new modular F1 truck platform, the Tundra also incorporates a brand new infotainment system, and it eschews V8 power altogether in favor of a pair of twin-turbocharged 3.5-liter V6 engines, one of which is hybridized. I'm definitely gonna miss the roar of that V8 when you're towing into the throttle, but in every other way, this vehicle looks very tantalizing. Now, before I get ahead of myself, please be sure to subscribe to the Motor One YouTube channel and find us on all of your favorite social media using our handle at MotorOne.com. But for now, let's dig in. You can very plainly see that the new Tundra is much bolder and more expressively styled than the outgoing truck, starting with this massive center grille that visually links to the front bumper courtesy of this interlocking radiator shell. On every trim level, you get this big C-shaped piece of material that kind of ties everything in. I actually don't love the way that this looks. It looks much larger and more gaping than the old truck did, which is actually why I kind of prefer vehicles that have a body color painted center section to just break up this massive wall of black. But truck customers love aggressive, and this definitely qualifies. Over here, we've got these interesting T-shaped headlights, T for Toyota, T for Tundra, that frame actually functional secondary fender vents that are here to optimize aero around the vehicle. Moving around to the side, you can plainly see that this vehicle has blacked out A and B pillars, which make the daylight opening appear larger and more seamless, giving the Tundra a slightly more modern appearance compared to other full-size trucks. There's also chunky and chiseled fender flares that give the truck a nice planted stance, which is just what you want in a pickup truck. And along the side, an integrated rear bumper cleans up the profile just a little bit more to give it just that extra bit of polish.
Pop open the tailgate and you'll find a sheet molded composite bed just like the smaller Tacoma, reinforced with aluminum to stand up to the truck's 1,940-pound maximum payload. Meanwhile, the fully boxed F1 chassis helps the Tundra tow up to 12,000 pounds. Hauling that weight around is the job of a standard twin-turbocharged 3.5-liter V6 that makes a healthy 389 horsepower and 479 pound-feet. If that's not enough grunt, Toyota will also offer an iForce Max hybrid powertrain, mating the same Turbo 6 with a single electric motor for a staggering 437 horsepower and 583 pound-feet of torque. That's more than many diesels, including the old Nissan Titan XD's 5-liter Cummins V8. A heavy nickel metal hydride battery lives under the rear seat, which actually means maximum towing and payload capacity go down a few hundred pounds compared to the non-hybrid V6.
In addition to all that power, there's a fantastic new interior that will help console customers over the loss of the V8 engine. First off, there is a big and bold 14-inch touchscreen display on some models, but even the base truck gets an 8-inch display standard, which is a huge improvement over the old vehicle. Additionally, it's really easy to use and much more responsive to touch than the old machine, and it offers voice recognition capability, as well as over-the-air updates that mean that it can stay current as new features and technology come out. Styling-wise, the new vehicle is also a big upgrade over the old Tundra. There's a pretty cool metallic cross-car beam that kind of provides some modern structure to the interior and visually supports the dash vents and the infotainment display, and the low dash also preserves outward sight lines. In fact, the only complaint that I can really find about this interior is that in the back seat on vehicles with a panoramic sunroof, my head brushes the headliner every time I get in and out. It's kind of annoying, and it's a bit of a disappointment considering how spacious the old Tundra was. That said, the drop-down rear window, which is a carryover from the old truck, is one of my favorite features on any Toyota product ever, alleviating claustrophobia significantly and providing fantastic ventilation or a great place for your dog to stick his head out the window. As nice as this interior is, current Toyota enthusiasts are probably more interested in off-road capability, so let's go check out the flagship TRD Pro trim. Based on the luxurious limited trim level, the TRD Pro adds an aluminum front skid plate, locking rear differential, forged alloy wheels, and luxurious feeling Softex faux leather upholstery with a very cool camouflage pattern in the seats. Additionally, digital camo appears on the fender flares, and as you can see, the truck just looks fantastic. This truck isn't just about appearances though, because there are some new Fox internal bypass shocks and a revised suspension geometry that provide better wheel control and improved ground clearance relative to the standard Tundra. Toyota isn't ready to cop to specific numbers just yet, but if you check out under the vehicle, you can see that all of the sensitive components are tucked up high to prevent accidental damage out on the trail. The TRD Pro will also come standard with the hybrid V6, and that instantaneous electric torque will be a huge boon in low-speed off-road driving, as will crawl control and multi-terrain select, both of which make their debut on the Tundra for the 2022 model year. New Tundras don't come around that often. I mean, the last time Toyota introduced a full-size truck was way back in 2007, for heaven's sake. However, it's clear that engineers took those intervening 15 years to make this vehicle as good as it possibly could be. While I'm going to miss the bellow of the 5.7-liter V8, the 3.5-liter V6 should be even more powerful and more fuel efficient, with the hybrid powertrain improving even further still. Combined with a spacious and comfortable interior and hopefully impressive off-road capability, the 2022 Toyota Tundra should be just as appealing as the old one, and that makes me very happy indeed. Thanks for watching.